Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah. Ashhadu an la أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Just a reminder to the brothers and the sisters that during the khutbah, texting, answering the phone, checking your news feed, all of this is haram and batil. You can't do any of this during the Jumu'ah khutbah. It doesn't matter if the president called during this time. This is the time that you're supposed to be directing your attention to the statements of Allah and His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to put the importance of this Jumu'ah khutbah in our hearts and let everything else be put to the side, just for the small time. It's not a long time. 30 minutes at the top, inshallah. Jazakumullahu khairan. For indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created us Muslims and everyone in reality and existence to worship Him. As we say this constantly, this is a reminder for us constantly that we were created to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But this worship that we have for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not just anything that you or I can make up. This worship, as has been described, is ismun ja'nu ma yuhibbu Allah yarda. That worship is anything that Allah is pleased with. Anything that Allah loves from your actions or statements, that which is inside, the inner actions and the outer actions. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with it, if Allah loves it, then that's what we were created to do. And if Allah is not pleased with it, and Allah does not love it, then it really has no place in our life. And the next thing that we have to realize is that this worship that we were created for, there's no way for you or for me to make up or to bring about or to think about a way to please Allah except that His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam showed it and taught it to us. There's no way for us to figure out a way to love Allah, to please Allah, except that our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam showed it and taught it to us already. This is the scale that we have to utilize in our regards to our actions to see if it's pleasing to Allah or not. For none of us have received message from Allah. None of us have had Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam come and tell us that Allah is pleased with something. This has ended in the start. This has ended with our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. As Allah Ta'ala He mentions, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهُ يَغْفِرُ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gave us the scale which we will find the pleasure of Him. He told us that if you love Allah, say, if you really love Allah, follow the Messenger, follow Him. Allah will love you if you do this, and He will forgive your sins. There is no one else that Allah has told us to follow unconditionally. There is no one else that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us that if we follow Him, that we will earn His pleasure. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did and fulfilled his job. As Allah revealed from amongst the last of the ayat revealed upon our blessed Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah told us about that which is pleasing to Him. He said, أَلْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. That Allah ta'ala, He said, I have completed this day, I have completed your religion. This is one of the last ayat revealed to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this day I have completed your religion. Your deen is complete. There is nothing that can be added to it after. وَأَتْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ نِعْمَتِي. And I have fulfilled, completed my favor upon. This deen is a blessing from Allah. وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. And I am pleased with Islam to be your deen. So whatever was the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during the time of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that and only that is what Allah is pleased with. As the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he stood in front of his companions, over 100,000. Some scholars, they say 140,000 companions. I'm hajjatul wada'. And he stood in front of them, and he asked them, he said, Allah hal balagd. He said, have I fulfilled my job? Have I fulfilled my mission? He's asking them to bear witness for them. Qalu na'am. They said, na'am. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allahumma shahadi. Oh Allah, bear witness that I have fulfilled my job. I have fulfilled my duty. That what you sent me with, I have completed. So if a person comes today, alhamdulillah, and says that they have a way that's pleasing to Allah, a way that Allah will love them, have an action that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with, that His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not do, that He's lied upon the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He's lied upon the companions. It said that he's found something that is pleasing to Allah. He's found a path that will reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that his messenger did not bring. This means that our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the last and final messenger, did not fill his job. This is one of the worst lies that a person can bring. And this is one of the worst sins that a person can come with. That a person innovates and brings about a new way in the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There will be no pleasure attached to this from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rather, the one who innovates in the deen of Allah will earn the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is upon the one who innovates and brings upon new affairs in the deen of Allah. And it will not be accepted from them. As the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَنْ أَحْدَثَ فِي أَمْرِنَا هَذَا مَا لَيْسَ مِنْهُ فَهُوَ رَجُلٌ. That whoever innovates and brings about something new into this deen of ours, it will be rejected. No acceptance for this action. No pleasure from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come in the action of the one who does such. As well, he said, مَنْ عَمِلَ عَمَلًا لَيْسَ عَلَيْهِ أَمْرُنَا فَهُوَ رَدْ. Whoever does an action, even if they didn't make it up themselves, but they follow it, and they do it, and it is not in accordance to the deen of Allah, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not bring it, it will be rejected. It will be rejected and not accepted from Allah. This person will be wasting their time and earning the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not alone will the action of this one be rejected, but this person will be maqrood as well. This person will be rejected and turned away from the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As it comes in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, إِنِّي فَرَتُكُمْ عَلَى الْحَوْدِ. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's speaking about his hawd, that the believers, the people of the sunnah, those who stuck to the kitab of Allah and the sunnah of his Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, those will drink from the hawd of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we ask Allah to make us amongst those who drink from his hawd. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنِّي فَرَتَكُمْ عَلَى الْحَوْدِ. That I will precede you. I will be there waiting for you on the hawd. Subhanallah. What person who loves the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, who loves the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is from the greatest of good news for one. That he knows that if I follow the way of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and I stick to that, that I'll meet the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I'll be his companion in the Qiyamah, and I'll drink from his hawd. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I'll be there waiting for you. And then he said, مَنْ مَرَّ عَلَيَّا شَرِبْ. Whoever passes by me will drink from it. وَمَنْ شَرِبْ فَمَنْ شَرِبْ لَمْ يَضْمَنْ أَبَدًا لَمْ يَضْمَ أَبَدًا. And whoever drinks from this hold, subhanAllah, they will never be thirsty again. They will never be thirsty again. لَرْيَدَنَّ عَلَيَّ أَقْوَامٌ. They said, there will come a people, أَعْرِفُهُمْ وَيَعْرِفُونِ. They will come to me while I'm at the hold. I'll know them and they'll know me. ثُمَّ يُحَالُ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَهُمْ. But then there would be a shield placed between me and them. Even though I know them and they'll know me, there'll be a barrier to be placed between me and them. They won't be able to drink at my hold. As it comes in another narration clarifying it further, from the hadith of Abi Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu, he says to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, will say, فَأَقُولُ إِنَّهُمْ مِنِّي. He'll say, I will say they're from me, they're my followers. This is where he'll cry out, when he'll see them. He'll recognize them to be from his ummah. فَيُقَالَ إِنَّكَ لَا تَدْرِي مَا أَحْدَثُ بَعْدَكَ. Then it will be said to him, but you don't know what they innovated after you. You don't know what they changed, what they brought about in the deen of Allah after you, that you didn't bring. So the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after you says, سُحْتًا سُحْتًا لِمَنْ غَيِّرَ بَعْدِي. He will say, suhkan, suhkan, suhkan is a word that means may they be far removed from any blessings. May they be removed from any good. Suhkan, suhkan liman ghayyara ba'di. For whoever changes the deen after me, whoever came with something new after the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they won't be close to him. They won't drink from his house. Rather, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will make dua that they will be removed far from away from him. May Allah protect us from this. But this is the seriousness, barakallahu feekum, of sticking to the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We don't say the sunnah is sunnah just because it sounds good. The sunnah is our salvation, barakallahu feekum. The sunnah is our only way to earn the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we turn away from the sunnah, we earn the anger of Allah. Imam Ibn Abdul Barr, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, كُلُّ مَنْ أَحْدَثَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ. He said, whoever makes a bid'ah, whoever brings about something new in the deen of Allah, they will be al-matruudin al-hawl. They will be removed far from the hawl. Kal-khawarij wa-rawafid wa-sa'id ashab al-ahwa. He says, such as the khawarij and the rawafid, and anyone who follows their desires over the text of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah protect us all from following our desires and leaving that which the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إن الله غفور رحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين وبه نستعين على أمور الدنيا والدين. وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد خاتم النبيين وآله وصحبه أجمعين ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. So we say, my dear brothers and sisters, that the participation or celebration of this clear bid'ah of the mawlid of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which in reality is not even the mawlid of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because his actual birthday is not known. The scholars have over 15 different opinions over the actual date of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's birth. But the reality of this bid'ah of the mawlid of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we warn ourselves and our families and our brothers and sisters from participating in this event. We warn the Muslims from participating in this innovation, as it will wallahi, it is something that will cause you to be of the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to come down upon those. It has not earned the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if it earned the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then for sure the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would have been the first one to celebrate it. If it earned the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then for sure Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu would have been the first to celebrate it. Then if it was the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for sure Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu would have celebrated it. As it comes in the hadith, we have to pay attention to our own reality. There is no way possible that you or I can love the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than Abu Bakr or Umar or Aisha radiallahu anhu. As the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked by Amr ibn al-As radiallahu anhu, he came to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, "Ayyu nas ahabbu ilayk?" He said, "Whom from amongst the people are most beloved to you, Ya Rasulullah?" The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, "Aisha." He said, "Aisha," his wife. Then he said, "Min al-Rijal?" No, from the men. He said, "Abuha." And he said, "Thumma man?" He said, "Umar ibn al-Khattab." So we see that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he bore witness that the people who were most beloved to him was Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. Then he said his wife Aisha radiallahu anha. Then he said Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. Then he said Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. Do we have any history of these people who loved the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam celebrating his birthday, making a special occasion for his birthday, when he himself bore witness that they loved him more than any of us could? As well as it comes in the hadith of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, that it says that كنا مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو آخذ بيد عمر بن الخطاب, that we were with the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم and he was holding on to the hand of Umar ibn al-Khattab. So Umar رضي الله عنه said, "Ya Rasulullah, لأنت أحب إلي من كل شيء إلا من نفسي." Umar ibn al-Khattab said, "Ya Rasulullah, you are the most beloved thing to me. You are the most beloved to me more than anything except myself. You know, I love myself a little bit more." So the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, "وَالَّذِي نَفْسِ بِيَدِي لَا حَتَّى أَكُونَ أَحَبُّ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ نَفْسِ." He said, "No, until I'm more beloved to you, even more than your own self." So Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, "الآن يا رسول الله." Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, "فَإِنَّهُ الْآنَ وَاللَّهِ لَأَنْتَ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِنْ نَفْسِ." He said, "Now, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are more beloved to me even than my own self. Even more than my own self." And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Al-an, Umar." He said, "Now, you have achieved." So we learn from here that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he didn't ask Umar to celebrate my birthday, then you will love me. He didn't say, "Umar, where's my birthday celebration? We don't see you do anything special for my birthday." The love of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam comes from following his sunnah. The love of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam comes from following his way, calling to it, defending him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It does not come from innovating in the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi, there is so much in the deen of Allah that we do not do. We don't have time to make up anything. There's so much that we have not accomplished in the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How do we have time to innovate and make up things? And we see and we notice from that which is the reality that majority of the people that we see celebrating the mawlid, they don't even come to Jumu'ah. They don't even fulfill the obligations of the deen. But they want to add and do extra stuff. These people who celebrate the mawlid, most of the time, they shave their face. But they want to say they love the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Show us in your actions that you love the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Don't make up anything. The deen is enough for us. Allah has given us that which is sufficient for us. Stay away from this. Barakallahu feekum. Don't earn the anger of Allah by trying to do that which Allah did not reveal. Don't anger Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by doing that which His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never did. and which his companions, radiallahu alayhim, never did. So we should ask ourselves, if they didn't do it, how can we try to do it? If they didn't do it, and they loved the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than we could ever, how can we think that we can come and do something that which is beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which they didn't do? اللهم أرنا الحق الحق وزدنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطل وزدنا اجتنابه ولا تجعله ملتبسا علينا فنضل اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك وأقيم الصلاة